Lastly, I would like to turn now to the last topic, which is about tetanus. As most of us might be aware, in the past 2 years, we've been faced with the problem of tetanus in the VMMC program. This is not only limited to Uganda, but as you can see, it has been observed in Kenya, in Rwanda, Tanzania, and Zambia. So it is a problem that is affecting the program, and we need to find ways to mitigate this risk. And review of these cases, we've seen that 8 of them had consistent causal association with VMMC. Therefore, as a VMMC program, we cannot just sit back and look on as this problem keeps on going. In Uganda, when we came to know about this problem, we conducted a review of our data through the that comes through the DHIS system, and we realized that half of the population we are targeting for circumcision may not actually be having the required level of protection that is offered through the DPT vaccines. So that definitely tells us that we need to do something about the target population if we are to mitigate the tetanus risk. So, as a country, what are some of the interventions we've put in place to mitigate this risk? First and foremost, World Health Organization has recommended major approaches for mitigating the risk. One is the clean care approach, which we think we've been implementing to prevent other adverse events, but we need to further strengthen. And more important is to integrate the tetanus toxoid vaccine within the program. As we've seen from the previous slide, about 50% of the target population may not be having adequate levels of protection against tetanus. So the Ministry of Health took up the recommendation from World Health Organization to integrate tetanus toxoid into the program. And we agreed the country to use existing EPI structures, not to do this as a standalone intervention, and to make sure that sites are ready for that intervention, we developed a tool to help us to assess the sites for their readiness to integrate TT within the program. We, with the leadership of Ministry of Health and other implementing partners, we embarked on the process of modifying our existing tools, that is the client data collection tools and reporting tools, to integrate information on tetanus and tetanus toxoid so that we are able to capture information related to the risk, to the vaccination, and to the follow-up visits as far as tetanus toxoid is concerned. We've gone through the process of reorienting service providers on tetanus vaccination. As you can imagine, of course, the VMMC program, we are targeting so many people. So the existing staff under the EPI may not be enough to offer the expected, to be able to attend to all the clients that we expect to receive within the VMMC program. And secondly, we use two approaches of static and mobile and outreach services to reach the VMMC clients. So we wouldn't want to take the EPI staff from the static clinic to the mobile clinics of VMMC. So we found it important to orient and train new service providers on to be able to give the TT vaccine. We are supporting teams to test changes to improve the uptake of TT, the return rates for VMMC, and also management of the tetanus cases should they occur. And definitely we are documenting all that we are learning, and we shall be able to share it in the near future. So when World Health Organization recommended integration of TT into the program, there are different approaches that we could do this. I'm not going to spend too much time explaining this graph, but what we are doing in Uganda, we are giving two shots. The first shot 4 weeks before VMMC and the second shot on the day of VMMC. What results have we seen to date? We've realized that uptake of the first shot of TT is very high. When you give information to the clients about TT, acceptability is very high. And the majority of the clients who receive information on TT, one, they end up taking it. The challenge has been TT2, which is supposed to be given 28 days later. As you can see from this graph, in December, we had a big gap between the number of clients who receive the first shot and the number of clients who receive the second shot. But we've supported the teams to address that gap, and as you can see, the gap has narrowed over time. And some of the key changes we've tested include staff orientation on documentation. Some sites were giving clients TT1, and they wouldn't know whom to expect for TT2, and the clients would get lost in the community. So we had to improvise a way of recording the clients who receive the first shot, get their details, contact details, so that in case they don't come back, you're able to follow them up. There was no standard register for that, so the teams were improvising with the counter books. Then they generate lists of clients who have missed their appointments for the TT2, and they make follow-up. And also, we've noted that making reminder calls to the client in between 4 weeks is a long time. Some people get busy, so they need reminders to tell them that you received the first shot of TT and you're due for the second shot and also due for circumcision. And this has helped us to bridge the gap between the two groups of clients. So what lessons have we learned to date regarding integration of tetanus toxoid in the program? First and foremost, we've observed, of course, that adding these two shots have slowed down the demand. That is a fact that we need to appreciate, but we cannot run away from it, and we have to find ways of making sure that we address it. We've realized that there's need to improve documentation of clients who receive TT1 so that we can follow them up to come back for TT2. We've also noted that it is important to harmonize the visit for TT2 with the circumcision visit. What was happening at some sites, TT1 is commonly given in the community. Some sites were also giving TT2 in the community, and then they go ahead and tell clients, come to the health unit for VMMC. That was causing dropouts. So we've realized that it is better give TT1 in the community, and then TT2 is given at the VMMC clinic, so that you receive TT2 and also receive the procedure. And definitely we've seen that reminders between the two visits are very important in terms of improving the uptake. I thank you so much for listening to me, and I now hand over back to the moderator.